Good morning, students. So in our previous class we saw about estimation of the fundamental operations by rounding off, by finding actual and estimated sum, by verifying them. Okay, so today we are going to see another type of numeration. We use Indo-Arabic system of numeration, Indian number system, international number system. So in that number system we use Hindu-Arabic system. So there is one more type of system, so that uses symbols, that is used in mostly in Roman. It is originated in ancient Roman, Rome, old, ancient. So it is known as Roman numerals. Using the pictures of hands or figures, these symbols are used. Okay, so those are seven symbols. Roman numerals, they use seven symbols, which starts from one, that is I, one. Okay, one more important thing is that in Roman numerals they doesn't use zero, means there any symbol is not there for zero. So only that this is not mostly accepted. These Roman numerals are not accepted universally because it doesn't contain zero. Okay. So there are seven symbols. You can see here I have made by using this sticks, ice cream sticks. You can make these Roman numerals symbols by using different things like matchsticks or straws, or you can use innovative, like by using the leaves. By different method you can make these Roman numeral symbols, seven symbols. You have to do this activity. You have to make these seven symbols by not using these ice cream sticks or matchsticks, by using a different method. Okay, any other idea? Okay, seven symbols. Now here you can see this first, this is I. So it represents, first symbol is I. In seven symbols, first symbol is I. In Indo-Arabic, it is represented as one. Next is, you can see here V, then X, L, then C, D and M. Okay, so these are seven symbols. V, X, L, C, D and M. Now, these are seven Roman numerals. Now, in Hindu-Arabic what it represents? I means 1, V is 5, X is 10. L is 50, C is 100, D 500 and M is 1000. So these seven symbols are used. By using these, by there are some rules. By using those rules we can make other numbers. Okay, other numbers. Now here, see here, I 1. So first, before making the numbers, we will see the rules. Rules which for writing the Roman numerals. By using these rules, we can easily write the numbers. Now, first is, if here the symbol is, these symbols can be repeated, but it can be repeated more than three times. Only these symbols can be repeated. For example, this I means 3 times. If you repeat like this, okay. And some otherwise you can see B I like this. You have to repeat only 3 times. X. You can't repeat. This is first rule. We have not to repeat Roman numerals more than 3 times. Second is these 3 symbols B, L, and D. They are not repeated. They will be written only once. Only I, X, and C and M. I, X, C, M. Only those symbols can be repeated. Okay, this is second rule. Now third rule is when we write the smaller. Now here you can see V means 5, it's greater, and here I is smaller. So when you merge, smaller symbol is written to the right side. That means we have to add. This addition is here V 5. I is 1 plus 1. So if we add it, we will get 7. So meaning of this symbol is 7. V-I-I, 7 means we have to add. That means the third rule is this, when the smaller symbol is written to right side, we have to add. When the smaller symbol is written to left side, now I, X. Now here I is 1. X is 10. So if this becomes here 10 minus 1. So this is 9. 10 minus 1. So you have to remember whenever smaller symbol is written to the left side, that means it is subtraction. We have to subtract. So these are some rules. Now, where we can use this Roman numerals in our day-to-day life? You can see your classes are represented by using these symbols. First, second, third, fourth. You are there, you are in sixth standard, so you will write six like this. Fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth. So these here we can use the Roman numerals. And some places the big clocks will be there. There also we can use Roman numerals. And to represent the historical events, now for example World War 1, World War 2. So like in some places these Roman numerals are used. Okay, now here you can see that till 1000 only it is there, and we know that in these symbols we can repeat only 3 times. So the Roman numerals, like Hindu Arabic, they are countless. Roman numerals, they are only till 3000, because MMM, 1000 plus 1000 plus 1000. Only 3000 only is there? No, we can again write these by using bars. Now for example, V bar. V bar means we have to multiply this 5 with 1000. Okay, multiply with 1000 bar, this bar. So we can make 5000. If in L bar means 15,000. That is 50,000. So we can make bigger numbers also in Roman numerals by using these bars. Okay, so these are some rules. Now we will see some examples based on this Roman numerals. Okay. For example, if we have now, if Hindu Arabic number is given 549. So here 549. How will you write it, Roman numeral? Now 500. This what we have to do? We have to separate it, split it. 500 plus 50 plus 9. Now 500, how will you write? What is the symbol for 500? It is D. For 40, 40 means 50 minus 10, that is XL, and 9 is IX. So here DXLIX. So like this, we can convert the bigger into Arabic number into Roman numeral. We'll take again 835. So 800 plus 30 plus 1. 800 is how much? 800. 500 plus 300. So 800 also you can split. 500 plus 300. 500 is how much? 500 means D with symbol, and then 100, 300 we can split as 100 plus 100 plus 100. So that is CCC, because 100 is C, so, and 500 is D. So DCCC, that is 800 plus 30. X is 10, so 3 times X, and 5 is D. Okay, like that your birth date, also you can write your 5 friends birth dates in Roman numerals by using this symbol. Okay, you can convert, you can write the birth dates or your family number, family members birth dates, you can write, you can paste that by using different materials on a sheet. Okay, instead of making these symbols, you can make that activity also. You can take 5 members or your any, how many members are there in your house, you can take their birth dates, and those birth dates or birth year, you can write the birth year in Roman numerals by using different materials. Okay, now we'll see one example how to convert Roman numeral into CLXVII into Hindu Arabic. Now here you can see CL. So C means it is greater, 100. L is 5. L is 50. So we have to write the symbol value. So C is 100 plus L is what? L is 50 plus X is 10 plus VII is 7. Now this we can add 167. Okay, one more example we'll take. Now here you can see CD. D is greater and C is smaller. So that means that is some their difference will be there. So it is 500 minus 100, that is 400. So 400 plus XXX, that is 10 plus 10 plus 10, 30 plus 9. IX means 9. So it is 430. So like this, we have to convert this Roman numerals into Indo-Arabic and Indo-Arabic into Roman numerals. Thank you.